Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Math School Learn to Succeed. In this channel, I'll be teaching you Karnataka Board Class 10th SLC NCERT Math. So in today's video, let us learn some of the end terms of an AP from section 1.4, chapter number 1, Arithmetic Progressions. I have solved all the examples and the questions related to the exercise 1.1 and 1.2. If you have not watched that videos, please find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. I'll be uploading all the videos in my channel related to SLC NCERT Math. Please like my video and subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell button below to get the latest updates of my videos. So this is the section 1.4 from chapter number 1, Arithmetic Progressions, which says sum of the first n terms of an AP. So first of all, let us understand what is this sum of first n terms of an AP. So we already know how to write the general form of an AP. So let us first of all write down the general form of AP, which is given by the first term A or A1, the second term A2, third term A3, term is A4, and so on until the nth term An. So we can find out the first term A and the common difference D, or we can find out the any term of an AP, or we can find out the nth term also given these values. These type of problems we solve in the previous exercise, right? So in this section, we will be learning these how to find out the sum of the first n terms of AP. What does this mean? The sum of the first n terms of AP means, for example, if you want to find out the first four terms of AP, then this is given by A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4. Okay, this will be the if you add the first four terms of an AP results, you will get the sum of the first four terms of an AP. So for example, if you consider an AP given by 4, 8, 12, 16, let the end term be 84. Okay, now if you see here, the sum of the first four terms of AP will be 4 plus 8 plus 12 plus 16. That is 4 plus 8 is 12. So 12 plus 12 is 24 plus 16 will be 40. Okay, this is the first four terms of an AP. So here we found out just the first four terms of an AP. For example, they ask us to find out the first 30 terms of an AP or first 40 terms of an AP. How will you find out? We have to keep adding all the terms. We have to first of all find all the 21 terms. Then we have to add them, and then we will find the value. Instead, we can derive a formula which will give us the sum of any n terms of an AP. So let us see how to derive a formula to find out the sum of n terms of an AP. So there is a similar example given in the textbook. So let us see this example. Shakila puts rupees 100 into her daughter's money box when she was 1 year old, rupees 150 on her second birthday, rupees 200 on her third birthday, and will continue in the same way. How much money will be collected in the money box by the time her daughter is 21 years old? So Shakila puts rupees 100 in the money box in the first year of her daughter's birthday, and rupees 150 in the second year, 200 in the third year. Likewise, she will be continuing until daughter turns 21 years old. And now we have to find out the sum of the money collected from the first year to the 21 years. Since we know that the common difference between the term is 50, we should find out the terms till the 21st term, and then we have to add all the terms together to get the sum of the money collected in the 21 years. Okay, instead of doing this, we can simply derive a formula to find the sum of the first n terms of an AP, and we can find out the result of this example using that formula. So first of all, let us see how to derive the formula. So let us consider the problem given by Gauss to find out the sum of the n terms of an AP. Gauss was a greatest mathematician about whom it is mentioned in the chapter number 8, Real Numbers. These videos I have already uploaded, guys. If you have not watched this video, please find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. And it is page number 154 from your textbook. Basically, he was asked a question, sum of positive integers from 1 to 100. Immediately, he gave an answer that 5050. So let us find out how did he find out this result so easily. He added first positive 100 terms, that is from 1 to 100. He wrote down in this manner, then he reversed the numbers to write down, that is initially he wrote from 1 to 100, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus until 99 plus 100. Again he reversed this pattern and he wrote 100 plus 99 plus until 3 plus 2 plus 1. Then he added these two terms. He added the 1 with 100, then 99 plus 2, then 3 plus 98. Similarly here he added 98 plus 3, 99 plus 2, and 100 plus 1. Okay, then he found out the answer. Here we are getting 2s because he added both the series of the terms, so he got 2s here. So what is 100 plus 1? It is 101. Again 99 plus 2 is 101. Likewise he got the result 101 for all these 100 terms. Here we are taking all this as 100 terms because we took terms that is 1 to 100, so these are the 100 terms. Then we got 100 into 101 divided by 2, so the 2 which was here was sent to the right hand side, so it is in the division form. So 100 into 101 by 2, we get the result 5050. So this is the sum of the first positive 100 terms. Okay, this is how he found out the result. So this trick of Gauss we will apply to our AP and find out the first n terms of an AP. To find the sum of the n terms of an AP, so let this be the AP, that is AX is the first term, this is the second term A plus D, this is the third term A plus 2D until the nth term AN. So let S denote the sum of the first n terms of an AP, and the nth term of an AP is given by A plus N minus 1 into D. This we already know. Let us take the AP, sum of the first n terms of an AP. The first term is A, second term is A plus D, the third term will be A plus 2D. Likewise, the nth term AN is A plus N minus 1 into D. This is the formula for the nth term which we have written here. Okay, now we are going to reverse this addition and we are going to write terms. So rewriting the terms in the reverse order. Okay, so how we did in the Gauss technique, we are applying the same technique here and we are writing down the terms. So we have reversed the terms. So the nth term is coming here. What is the term before this will be A plus N minus 2 into D. Okay, similarly the term before this will be A plus N minus 3 into D. Okay, that is what is written here. So the first term becomes A plus N minus 1 into D here, and the second term is A plus N minus 2 into D, and the last terms will be the first terms of this addition, that is the last term is A, the term before is A plus D, and the term before this will be A plus 2D. After adding this 1 and 2 term wise, we will get the result as S plus S is 2S. So here we will add this term A with this term, the first term of this addition. So A plus A will be 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Okay, now this term A plus D will be added to this term A plus N minus 2 into D. Let me add this and show you here. See, A plus D plus A plus N minus 2 into D. If you open these brackets, you'll get A plus D plus A plus N D minus 2D. So A plus A is 2A and D minus 2D will be, so this will be 2A plus N D minus D. So if we take D common, it will be N minus 1. So likewise, we have got here 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Similarly, now this term is added with this term. Okay, and you get the result again 2A plus N minus 1 into D. You can add these two terms and you can check out the result. Similarly, this term is added with A plus D again, and you will get the result 2A plus N minus 1 into D. You can add these two terms and check out the result. Then again, the last term will be added with this last term, so you get again 2A plus N minus 1 into D. So here we can see that all the term result is 2A N into N minus 1 into D. Therefore, how many 2A plus N minus 1 into D are added? It is added N times because we took the N times in the AP. Therefore, we will get N into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. That is 2S is equal to N into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Now again, s is equal to this 2 value comes to the right hand side in the division form. So n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So this is how we found the result or the formula for the sum of the n terms of an AP. Okay, this is the formula, that is s is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So the sum of the first n terms of an AP is given by s is equal to n by 2 2a plus n minus 1 into d. This can also be rewritten as s is equal to n by 2 into a plus an. Here if you see, the formula for an is given by a plus n minus 1 into d. This one we are splitting the a plus a, so we will get n by 2 into a plus n minus 1 into d. So this whole term is nothing but an. So this is rewritten as n by 2 into a plus an. Now if there are only n terms in an AP, that is an is equal to l. N terms means if we know the last term. For example, in an AP they have given us 4, 8, 12, the last term is 84. Now we know the last term as 84. If the nth term we already know, then we can write the formula as s is equal to n by 2 a plus l, where l will be our last term, that is 84. So this form of the result is useful when the first and the last term is given. So the first term is a and the last term is l. So when the first term and the l, the last term is given, then this formula is very useful. Now let us go back to this example and solve which we had left in between. So this is an AP and we have to find out the sum of amount of money collected at the end of 21 years. So this is the money for the first year, second year, third year and the fourth year, and we have to find out the sum of money collected at the end of 21 years. Therefore let us use this formula, sum of the n terms of an AP given by which is given by s is equal to n by 2 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Now given this AP, we know the a value, that is the first term, that is equal to 100. And the common difference d will be the second term minus the first term, that is 150 minus 100, that is 50. We also know the n value, that is equal to 21, since we have to find the money collected for 21 years. So now let us find out the sum by substituting this value in the formula. Therefore s is equal to, what is the n value, 21 divided by 2 into 2 into a is 100 plus n value is 21 minus 1 into d is 50. So substituting we get 21 divided by 2 into, this is 200, if you open the brackets, 21 minus 1 is 20 into 50. Let us substitute the values in the brackets first. So 200 plus 20 into 50 will be 10, that is 1000. So this will be 21 divided by 2 into 1000, 200. So let us just cancel this term 2 times 2 6 times 0 0. So what is 21 into 600? So 6 ones are 6 6 twos are 12, and these 2 0 comes down. So therefore s is equal to 12,600 at the end of 21 years is 12,600. See how easily we could find out the result by just using one formula. Now using this formula, let us solve the example problems from the textbook. In my next video I'll be solving the examples from the section 1.4 from chapter number 1, arithmetic progressions. So till then, like my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.